Oh, they kept me late at the bank again. But I got my tap shoes on. This time Zangler's going to be dead. He's going to hire me on the spot. Oh, Mr. Zangler!
Our final performance of the season. But we hope you will all be back in just 8 weeks for a wonderful new show, yeah? Intimate supper. But Tessie, please, you make me crazy.
And who is this, Zangler?
I am sorry to say, she is in excellent health. Mr. Child, why are you wasting my time?
Because this is my life. It's all I care about. Now look, you're gonna love this, I promise.
Nothing. We would like it signed.
Fine. Do you have a pen?
Not by you, you idiot. By some other idiot who lives in Dead Rock, Nevada. I want you to go there immediately and get him to sign it.
Nevada?
It will save the bank quite a sum in foreclosure costs.
But I don't care about that. I want to dance, but I don't care about money.
I'm sorry.
He will go to Nevada over my dead body.
Oh, that sounds like an excellent room. Bobby, get in the car.
Charlie, don't.
Now, I will cut off my
out of the way.
Go out to Nevada first thing tomorrow morning. I don't want to hear any nonsense about it.
Bad news. Go away. Call round someday in March or May. I can't be bothered now. My bond and shares may fall downstairs. Who cares? Who cares? I'm dancing and I can't be bothered now.
If I have a downtime weekend, you get my Lord now, so it's out there, I'll allow it.
Thank you. Singing your heart out to a house full of drunken gold miners.
Just look at this. They're sending some banker out here to put the knife in. Name of Bobby Child. Bobby Child. If I ever meet up with that skunk, I don't know what I'll do, but it's gonna be ugly.
Well, I never seen her that mad before.
Talk about an exciting day.
Stop blathering, you pig-headed fool!
Blank Hawkins, don't you dare talk to my father that way!
Okay.
Ugh.
Look, I'll make it simple for you. I own the saloon!
I know that. Good.
Now, being a man of vision, I want to expand the saloon in the direction of your theater, which, if you'll recall, is now a post office, which was turned into one 20 years ago.
How I'd love to see another show in that theater again.
Everett, it's not gonna happen. In 2,000 years, there has been one resurrection, and it wasn't a theater. Think of it, Everett. This town could be big again. We could have shops and cafes, sidewalks. We could have another Cleveland on our hands.
But I like the place just as it is.
Would you look around, for God's sake? We got a town full of singing cadavers. We got bodies lying in the streets. We are the armpit of the American West.
Like Hawkins, you talk to my father again that way. You hear me?
If he doesn't sell it to me, the bank is just gonna take it anyway.
Things are looking up. I've been looking the landscape over, and it's covered with four-leaf clover. Things are looking up since love looked up at me. Was my cup, but no more will I be the mourner, for I've certainly turned the corner. Things are looking up since love looked up at me.
Bastion married me 15 times.
So ask someone else.
There is no one else. You're the only woman within 50 miles.
Polly?
Slow down, I gotta wash up.
Polly, my God, what a wonderful name. See, the sun beams, everyone beams, just because of you. session, and my depression is unmistakably through. Things are Mr. and Mrs. Us. Look at this place.
It's something, huh?
It's incredible.
Oh, when I was a little thing, I used to watch all the big shows out here. The music, the lights.
I've never seen anything like it. What's it doing here at Dead Rock?
This here was a pretty big town about 50 years ago. And the mines ran out. Everyone just kind of got left.
Look at this stuff. My God, I've never seen anything like it. Polly, you can't let the bank take this place.
How do you know about it?
Oh, well, I couldn't help overhearing. Out in the street. Hey, wait a second. I got an idea.
About what?
I know what to do.
What the hell are you talking about?
Look, okay, it's simple. All we have to do to save this place is to put on a show here in the theater. That'll give you all the money you need to pay the mortgage.
Just put on a show?
Right.
In here?
Right.
Is everybody this stupid back east, or are you just special?
Okay, well, why not? Okay, don't you go to the movies? Mickey Rooney does it all the time. The guys at the bar, they can sing. I heard him. And I can bring dancers from Zangler's Follies. They're my friends. They'll be here in a heartbeat. They're on vacation.
You mean Bella Zangler?
Yeah.
Oh, Dad's talked about him before. Do you know him?
Do I know him? Are you kidding? We're like this.
Do you think he'd come out here to help? I mean, if you asked him to?
No, but we don't need him, okay? I can do it, I promise. Look, Polly, let me try. I could accomplish something. And just think about it, giving this place a whole new life.
Well, I guess we could try it.
Okay, great. I'll call the girls first thing in the morning. Okay. Hey, take a look at this.
That's all right. Sure, it's nice of you to help like this. We hardly know one another. I'm Polly Baker.
Bobby Child.
What?
Bobby Child.
From New York City?
Right. Oh, God! What'd I do?
You're from the bank!
No, I can explain that.
Well, you're here to take our theater, ain't you? This is a trick.
No, it's not.
How would you do this to me?
Polly, you're wrong.
You and your singing and your dancing and your Bella Zangler.
Polly, I can save this place.
Go away! And don't ever let me catch you talking to me again.
Polly! You and your singing and your dancing and your Bella Zangler. Bella Zangler. Bella Zangler! Bella! Girls! It is time we pay a visit to Dead Rock, Nevada, yeah?
Thank you.
Yeah. Excellent. I'm looking, please, for Miss Polly Baker.
I'm Polly Baker. What's going on?
Permit me to introduce myself. I am Bella Zanger.
Get out of here, you really? Well, what are you doing here?
I come to save the evening.
What?
I'm getting a phone call 3 days ago from a very good friend of mine, Mr. Bobby Child. By the way, he's a wonderful boy. You should get to know him.
He did say you were friends.
Friends? We are like... these.
That's just what he said.
I am not surprised. So, we have show to put on, yeah?
Yeah! I don't believe one word of this.
And which word is that?
Something smells fishy to me.
Oh, I think it's moose! Oh, sorry. Oh, my goodness! Mr. Zangler?
You know me?
I've seen your picture 100 times in Variety. What are you doing here?
He came to help so we could pay the bank.
This is miraculous.
This is ridiculous.
Link!
This is insulting. Do you want me to put on show or not? Because I am busy now. Okay, I do the show. Girls, do work. Come on.
Gun?
Yeah.
It tends to have a mind of its own.
One out of two ain't back.
That isn't funny.
Why?
I want you out of here within 24 hours.
I wish you could have seen Polly's mother on that stage, standing in behind the footlights.
Mr. Zangler, I gotta tell you, if you can save this place well, I'm gonna be mighty grateful.
Let's hope so, yeah. So, who wants to audition? To be in show? To work with girls?
Now that's the kind of guy you should marry.
Good Dad, would you cut it out? When I'm ready to get married, I'll let you know.
By that time, you're gonna have to contact me through a medium.
I'm going to seek a certain lad. I am
another rehearsal, but I've been ready for a whole week.
Gaiety Theater and U.S. Post Office. Well, the show opens tomorrow night at 8. Oh, just get off at the junction and it's about an hour's walk. Hello? Hello?
Well, 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 busy bee, hard work.
Lank, this here's a theater and a post office. You can either buy a ticket or a stamp. Otherwise, go back to your saloon.
Oh, you're wasting your time. This show is doomed. You really think anybody's gonna pay good money to see a bunch of singing numbskulls?
Morning, Polly.
Morning, Pete.
What does this man know about theater, hmm?
Lay off him, Lank.
Tell us, sir, your views on the contemporary American stage.
Shucks, Mr. I don't know.
Shucks, Mr. I don't know. That sounds fairly trenchant.
Well, I suppose you could say that Eugene O'Neill is just beginning to explore the symbolism of Greek tragedy. Oh, of course, the realism of Anton Chekhov is an important influence. And then there's Stanislavski.
Thank you.
Bye, Lank.
Polly, wait a minute, Polly.
Well, spirited, ain't she? Sort of reminds me of that gal from King Lear.
Stop this show if it's the last thing I ever do.
Thank you.
Bailey, you try Bionic, yeah?
Okay. Hi.
Bobby?
Irene. Hi.
What the hell are you doing?
I'm putting on a show. I'm Bella Zangler.
You look like Karl Marx. Why in God's name would you dress up like some idiot in the middle of Nevada?
Well,
Mr. Zangler? Oh, hi. Mr. Zangler, I gotta tell you what you're doing here. It's like a miracle.
Oh, thank you.
I'll be right back. I gotta get these flyers up to Sky Bluff.
Okay. Take your time!
I should have known.
Irene.
You're doing it for her.
Well, not exactly.
Bobby, I saw that revolting look in your eyes, like a cow who needs milking.
Irene.
And I'm sure she'd love to hear all about the real you.
Oh, wait, no, come on, you wouldn't do that.
We are leaving here in the morning.
Oh, just wait one second.
Bobby, you're talking to a desperate woman.
Well, I can see that, but I don't understand why—
Mr. Zangler,
Polly, we have a visitor. Polly is only woman in Dead Rock, Nevada, yeah?
I guess that's why she looks so tired.
Okay. This is very old friend of mine.
Well, she sure moves good for her age.
My age? I suppose you just had your coming out party.
Coming out party? Oh, I never had one of those. I never even knew what that word meant till I saw that dress of yours.
Maybe you'd like to borrow it sometime.
Not till I'm buried.
Oh, okay, so she's making a joke now, yeah?
I guess it must look rather strange to you not having any leather fringe on it.
Well, that's all right, because your hair kind of makes up for it.
Okay, I knew you'd do a big good friend, so...
Mr. Zangler, may I have a word with you for a moment?
Yeah.
Listen, you, I want you out of here on the next train.
You don't like show?
No, I don't like show. I don't like you hanging around my woman all day.
You would prefer all night?
Maybe you should take a look at something.
Yeah.
Here, read that.
It's a vending license.
Have I made my intentions clear enough for you?
I guess so. I just simply don't want to marry you.
You're close to an idiot. That isn't funny.
Fine, then leave my theater.
I'm warning you, Zangler.
Look, I am a busy man. Now just go, go, go!
You haven't seen the end of me.
If it's anything like the front, I don't want to see it.
excuse me. You don't by chance have a hotel in this town?
Well, as a matter of fact, madam, I own that beautiful hotel next door.
Good. Can you give me a room and a bath?
I can give you a room, madam, but you'll have to take your own bath.
Important talk now, yeah?
Sure, what's up?
It is about Bobby Child.
Oh, Ann. I ain't seen him for days, which is lucky for him.
Oh, no, Polly. He is a wonderful boy. He is talented, handsome, brave.
Well, I ain't seen him for days, like I said. And that's really lucky for him.
Oh, no, but you don't understand. He is crazy for you.
Well, I can't help that. I'm already spoken for.
You are?
In my heart, anyway.
Oh, is that Lang person? Yeah, I don't like him. He is totally wrong for you.
It isn't Lang.
Moose?
You just don't understand anything, do you? Doesn't a man would storm up? I had to lock my door. Somehow I couldn't.
Sam?
What wasn't that to control me? What kept my love life free?
Blank, Moose, Pete,
my
Sam?
My intuition told me you belong on the sea.
Me?
Mister, listen to the rhythm of my heartbeat.
Uh-oh.
And you'll know just what I need.
Molly, we've got to talk about this.
Embrace me, my sweet embrace.
You're making a big joke, yeah? Okay.
Embrace me,
have his body.
Well, you even dance better than he does.
No, I don't think so.
Thank you.
poor Polly. He's just...
That's for luck.
Oh, everybody!
Everybody, I hear them coming around the bend! Get excited! Here they come!
Here they come!
Dead Rock Nevada.
That's your
answer.
Well, where's everybody else?
Everyone else?
From the train.
Oh, I didn't see anyone else on the train, did you, dear?
No. Oh, yes, there was that one rather older gentleman. I do believe we left the poor chap somewhere in the desert.
Frankly, I don't think he's going to make it.
Oh, yes.
So you mean there's just the two of you?
Afraid so. Is that going to be a problem?
No.
It'll be
just fine. I suppose you'd like to buy your tickets now.
Tickets?
Yeah, to see the show.
I'm afraid we're not here to see a stage show.
You're not?
No, you see, we're writing this old guide to the American West.
Yes.
We hope to do a series of them.
Okay.
This is my sister Patricia. The name is Fodor. I am here.
Now, let's see, we are here to review the Lank Hawkins Saloon, Bar, Hotel, and Restaurant.
Well. How do you do? Lank Hawkins, proprietor of said establishment.
Oh, lucky us.
Ah, yes, Mr. Hawkins, I do hope we are in time for dinner.
No. Bien sûr. Entrez.
Oh. Ah, yes, thank you very much.
The clouds part and justice reigneth supreme.
I can't believe it. After all that rehearsing.
Maybe. People are coming back home.
No. I wouldn't count on that.
I owe you all a very big apology, yeah?
It's not your fault.
Oh, but I'm afraid it is. I come to town, put on show, raise your hopes, and do not sell for you a single ticket. I am truly sorry.
Now, just because we didn't sell any tickets doesn't mean we're a failure.
In the theater business, it's a pretty good indication.
Well, out here it ain't. I mean, just look at all you've given us around. Before you came along, we were nothing but a bunch of lazy drifters. But we didn't do anything. And you showed up and something magic happened. And we've been working together and caring about things and feeling alive. Days can be sunny, but never a sigh. Don't need what money can buy. Birds in the trees sing, their day full of song. Why shouldn't we sing along? I chipper all the day,
Within reason.
I think I have an idea.
Mr. Hawkins!
What?
In case you're wondering, the coffee was cold, the food was inedible, and the cutlery was filthy.
Madam, if you don't like it here, I can show you the wide open spaces.
Oh, I have no desire to look inside your head.
I do not do shows in desert.
Well, we have the show. We need an audience.
Tess, this is middle of no place.
Well, get the word out. Advertise. You could do it.
Tess, it is impossible.
Fine. Don't ever kiss this neck again.
But Tessie.
What?
This is town full of morons.
That is so typical.
Tessie, please.
These are nice, normal, healthy people.
Hey, sugar.
You got it, Percy.
Hey, wait a second. Come on, boy.
Not anymore.
I said that to God.
Doesn't want me.
Bella, Bella, Bella.
Excuse me. Women. beside myself. She's so full of trickery. Life is bitter as chicory. Bitterness fills my cup.
I'm sorry you brought that up. Once I thought I'd search around for the little church around the corner, but now I see it never was meant to be.
Once she used to praise me.
Why is she so high-hat?
Why does she amaze me?
Tell me what causes that. When I'm away from her, I start despairing.
You ought to know by now what causes that.
I've got a pretty good idea.
Mortgage.
2 weeks.
Big deal.
Well, we gotta do something. I'd rather sell the place to Life than let the bank have it.
Tea?
Stop. This is your final notice. Stop. Sounds like an electric bill. Get back here on the next train. Stop. Don't stop. Stop. Will stop allowance if you stop. Stop. Your loving mother. Stop. P.S. Your uncle stopped by. I wish you would write letters. You okay? Holly.
Hello.
Is that you?
Morning, Bella. Uh-oh.
Bobby?
Hi. Well, I guess you believe me now. This is the best part. Ta-da!
Do you also do Jimmy Cagney?
Embrace me, my sweet embraceable you. Remember that? Embrace me. You irreplaceable.
Ow, Polly, ow!
Man! But you fell in love with me, you admitted it!
That was Zangler!
Me?
Not you!
There is third Zangler?
The one I cared about, the real Zangler!
But that's what I'm telling you, that's me!
You're Zangler?
Well, I'm not the real Zangler, but I'm Zangler.
Then who am I?
That's what I want to know.
I'm not so sure.
Oh, I don't even know who I kissed last night.
Me?
Oh no.
She kissed you too?
Of course she kissed me.
Had you met her before?
I fell in love with her.
That must have been some kiss.
Oh, would you two stop this?
Stop?
Stop!
Now you sound like my mother.
You made a jackass out of me.
No, I didn't.
You sure did?
I did not.
Maybe that was me.
Would you
stay out of this? No, but Polly!
I've never been so humiliated in my entire life.
I guess you won't be going to that meeting now, will you?
What meeting?
Down in the theater. We're deciding what to do.
She's thinking of selling the place to Leg.
Wait, but no, she can't do that. You can't let her.
It's gonna happen.
Okay, guys. What time does the meeting start?
In about 10 minutes.
All right, I gotta get changed. Just don't let the meeting start without me, okay?
Wait a second. Are you going as me or as you?
Me.
Good, then I can go as me.
There you are. Are you ready?
Look, I can't do this. I'm in a hurry.
Bobby, I have been waiting in this stinking town for 3 days.
But I just don't have time.
Well, make some time. I am your fiancé.
No, you're not. I'm sorry, but I'm in love with Polly.
Bobby.
Wish me luck, okay? You're a pal.
Bobby! Bobby, come back here! Bobby! Damn.
You haven't seen me.
Oh, Mr. Hawkins.
I say, Mr. Hawkins, I'm quite finished with that laundry yet.
No. Too sweet.
Oh, and we do hate to bother you again, but we'd love some croissants with our coffee. Now, is that too much to ask you?
Croissant? No.
Oh, isn't he silly? Oh, dear.
I suppose if they were found dead in the morning, there might be questions.
It does say hotel, you know, on the sign.
Excuse me?
The sign. It says hotel.
So it does. Well, we just have to do something about that now, shall we? Are there any other complaints?
You are a very frustrated man, aren't you?
Oh, Dr. Freud now, is it? Well, Doctor, what I really hate are stupid women from New York with their brains in their backside.
You are, without a doubt, the rudest, most uncouth, roughest man I have ever met.
Meadow!
If you
here?
We have to decide about the show. It's now or never.
I just love watching you kids perform. That's how I got started. I tap danced for about 10 years.
Wow! I get tired after 10 minutes.
Ever since you kids fixed this place up, I could look at it all day. It's just the way I remember it. I wish you could have seen Polly's mother on that stage.
Funny mustache?
Like hell I did.
Oh, you know you did.
I did not.
Well, this is off to a great start.
I ain't having this meeting with him here.
Well, you're gonna have to because I'm not leaving.
Patsy?
Can I go to the bathroom?
Yes. Bobby.
All right, guys, look. It's simple. We have 2 weeks left. Now we can try to do the show again or not. I think we should. Everett, what do you think?
Oh dear. Well, since we all worked so hard putting this place together to make it beautiful again, I'd rather that we all make a decision together. Polly?
Considering the circumstances, we've got no choice but to give it up.
What? How can you say that?
I wasn't talking to you.
Oh, for God's sakes, come on.
Well, we tried it once. It didn't work.
Yeah, but we can try it again. I mean, look at this place. It's a theater. We can give it a whole new life.
Hi.
Well, to tell you the truth, I just don't think I have the energy for it.
It was kind of depressing with only two people showing up.
Oh yeah, she's right. Yeah,
well,
right.
They didn't even come for the show.
I think it's kind of a losing cause, if you ask me.
See that you're all rather down in the dumps concerning this show of yours. But in our part of the world, we have a saying for this sort of thing. Stiff upper lip.
Carry on.
Chin up.
Stiff upper lip.
Carry on.
Chin up.
Stiff upper lip.
Stiff fellow.
Carry on, old fluff.
Keep modeling through.
Stiff upper lip, 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 st
Bobby. You know it won't work.
We tried it once.
I just don't think I have the energy for it.
Why bother if nobody comes?
Hey, guys, what happened to Stiff Upper Lip? Patsy! Well, at least we tried.
We sure did.
I'm sorry.
It ain't your fault. Entirely.
Well, so long.
Where are you going?
Back to New York.
You're leaving?
Well, there's nothing to keep me here now. Is there?
I guess not.
I guess not. Thanks.
For what?
A lot of fun. A few broken teeth. The way you wear your hat.
Meeting every train.
You got it.
You got it.
I
biggest mess up. It looks like happened here French Revolution.
So, I was right about these guys, huh?
The Cowboys. And they're okay.
Okay.
Tessie, I do this for you.
No kidding.
No kidding.
This isn't like you.
I know. That's what has me worried. Okay. Young lady?
Hi.
Hello. You know, you are a very good dancer.
Thanks.
Where did you learn this?
From a friend.
You are also a very good kisser.
Thanks.
So, there is your boyfriend. I got big news for him. I make him star of show. But I thought he was moron. He is moron. But he is talented moron.
He's gone.
Excuse me?
He's gone. He just left town.
Okay. That's your business, huh? We find someone else, huh? You could be star of show, huh?
Well, I don't think so.
Okay. Young lady, are you all right?
I'm fine.
Good.
Thanks.
property. Okay, what property?
This one!
Wait, are you kidding?
The Zangler Theater!
I own the theater?
It's all yours!
Oh my God!
You always wanted to dance on stage.
Oh.
Now you have a stage to dance on! Ain't you die?
Mother, come here, you're wonderful.
Hopefully this will keep you here in New York.
Wait, so I own the theater?
Mm-hmm.
The whole place?
Mm-hmm.
Every single uncomfortable seat?
Yes, I thought it would take you.
Oh, Mother, you have no idea. Wait. What happened to Zangler?
Oh, he couldn't meet the payments. Apparently he's wasting all of his money on that silly little theater in Nevada. I understand he's doing it for some woman.
He's doing it for Tess.
I don't know her name.
Oh my God.
Shall we look around?
Bobby, I'll be right there.
Holly. The man who plays for Holly.
house! You are star of show!
I don't care, I need to get out of here now! Custis! Where's Custis?
This is your fault! You raised prima donna!
Him that much?
I do.
Polly.
Oh, Dad, it's taken me 6 weeks to get my courage up. It's now or never. You can understand that, can't you?
I think so.
Thanks, Dad. Oh, Custis! Custis, can you give me a ride to the station?
Sure, Polly, but ain't you supposed to be on stage?
I don't have time to explain. The train leaves at 8:05. We'll just make it.
Okay.
Okay, great. I'll call you when I get there, Dad. Bye!
Ben?
Oh dear.
Oh, where is she?
I just left for New York. I'll quickly pick up.
But we have full house.
Mr. Ziegler, I think they're getting restless. They're throwing fruit at the curtain.
Oh, Betsy, do Polly's number. You go on for Polly, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Hey, here's no show. My cafe's in the sewer.
I am not magician. I put on show in 3 weeks. I spend all my own money. I give up my theater in New York. This is terrible. What am I going to do?
Hi, Bobby.
Hi, Bobby.
Bobby!
Where's Polly? I've got to talk to her.
Bobby, how did you get here?
I came in the car.
Now get back in it and go catch her.
Oh, I am never buying another foreign car. As long as I live.
What happened here?
The Zangler flies.
Oh my God. You managed to pay the mortgage?
We had full houses for 2 weeks. The problem is, Polly.
Wait a second. You mean, I did it. I managed to accomplish something.
Bobby! Can you show me this woman so I can go home?
Okay, I'll be right back.
Oh, wait. Bobby, she's not here. She went to New York to find you.
Your stupid machine was working.
All right, stand aside. I'll fix it.
Ah! Lonnie? Harry? What are you doing here?
I live here with my husband.
That is so typical. You have every chance in the world to get bumped.
But you were against the whole thing.
Well, would it be better than some cowgirl? You would get the other four off your bag, Bobby, but that's surprising. All you could do was walk about the cut of your dress.
Things are looking up. It's a great little world we live in. Oh, I'm happy as a pup since love looked up at me.
Can I help you, madame?
Well, somewhat better. Thank you so very much.
All right. Wish me luck.
Good luck, Bobby. But will he make it in time?
Well, what time is it?
It's 8:05. Impossible.
All right, well, look, never mind. I'll catch the next train. Just get the car on the road and I'll go wash up.
Are those two ever gonna get together?
Custis, I can't believe this.
Will you please stop yelling?